Hello there, God's special people, people with the opportunity to have a supernatural glow in good and in bad times. For the Bible says, them that look up to him, their faces shall be radiant, they shall lack nothing good, their faces shall not be covered with shame. Welcome to your weekly encouragement program, Meaningful 5 Minutes with Mommy Rita, where we use Bible tidbits to encourage ourselves amidst daily discouragements. We heartily appreciate you all for your views, your likes, your comments, your shares, your subscriptions, and all that you're doing to take us a step further in the work of the Lord. We also want to appeal to all those who have complained about their inability to watch the videos, that they should not click on the picture. Instead, they should click on the link. That way, they will be able to have access to the videos. By the special grace of God, we also want to announce the presence or the beginning of another gospel slot, which is Mommy Reads Meaningful Quotes, where we use Bible inspiration to come up with meaningful quotes. So immediately after every week's slot, you can just click on the next video for a less than 1 minute video where you have quotes that can bless you, that can encourage you, and also that you can share, you can comment, you can choose your best and drop a note on the comment section. And so every week, as soon as you receive Meaningful 5 Minutes video as a subscriber or as a viewer, please take time off to watch the next less than 1 minute video with meaningful quotes. And also, there's a picture collage for those who prefer that option. As we were saying, you already know that Jesus died for you and for me, and that is the reason why we are saved. And so, if you are out there and you have not yet given your life to Christ, my brother, my sister, remember that time waits for nobody. It will be good to do what you ought to do before it gets too late. We have also been able to share on several topics from slot 1 to 106, the last being the fact that we should plan properly, that many are the plans of a man, but it is the plan of the Lord that prevails, because the plans of the Lord are plans of good and not of evil. And the use of the definite article there means what God has destined for us will surely come to pass. And so in this new year, as we begin to plan, it is imperative for us to seek God's opinion, to know God's will for us in the place of prayer. Hallelujah. And so, having planned properly, having included God in our planning, today in slot 107, we'll be telling ourselves to face front. Hallelujah. We have as main passage Philippians chapter 3, from verse 12 to 14, where we are told to forget what lies behind and press on towards the goal. Beloved in the Lord, we live in a world where when someone decides to take a bold step or to go a step further in life, there are many things that can distract us. But we are encouraged in today's slot to face front and forget what lies behind. Some of the things that can cause us to begin to think of what has happened in the past is people's opinion. People can come to dissuade you, to discourage you, to scare you, to obstruct you. But what you have to remember is the fact that people will always talk. If as human beings we can talk about corpses, do you know, did you see how that corpse was dressed? Did you see how beautiful, how handsome, how we, if we can talk about corpses, how much more of the living? And so, beloved in the Lord, we have two ears at the sides, but two eyes at the front. And so, we should forget about what lies at the side and face front and focus on what lies ahead of us. Hallelujah. Sometimes, also, when you decide to face front, when you decide to make a move or to go further in something that you have already started, you can be reminded of your past mistakes. Maybe you did not get something right in the beginning, or maybe you have made mistakes in the past. But the Bible clearly tells us that in Luke chapter 9, verse 62, that he who holds the plow and keeps looking back is not fit for the kingdom of God. And so God is also telling us in Isaiah 43, verse 19, that behold, he is doing a new thing. And so don't focus on the mistakes of your past, on the errors, on the things you didn't get right, but focus on what lies ahead of you. Hallelujah. Another thing is uncertainty. When you begin to face front, you can begin to become insecure. You can start doubting that what is the guarantee that this thing that you have set out to do will eventually work. But remember that 1 Thessalonians 5:24 tells us that faithful is he who has called us. God has promised us and he will definitely keep his promise. We are told in Matthew 7 verse 11 that if we as human beings, bad as we are, can give good things to our children, how much more will our Heavenly Father give us good things? And so as you decide to face front, forget what lies behind and focus on the goal that is set before you. If you're out there and you have not yet given your life to Christ, just bow your head and say, Lord Jesus, come into my life, wash me with the blood of the Lamb, give me the power to live right, give me the power to hate sin. And behold, you will be facing front. You will be making a difference. You will be making yourself qualified to be able to focus on the things that God has in store for you. We are told in 2 Corinthians 5:17, if anyone be in Christ, he is a new creature. And behold, all things have passed away. And so as God has made all things to pass away in our lives, let us forget what lies behind and press on towards the goal so that we can get the prize. The Bible is the road, Jesus the code, sin the obstacle, and heaven the destination. Shalom, good people. And don't forget to take a look at your Mommy Reads meaningful quotes for this week. God bless you all.